Sebastian Rogers. He's going to be found sooner rather than later. So what's the dealio with this 15-year-old autistic child? So, you know, recently I saw the Foreman Brothers post about this. Josh did a spirit box session, and I'm like, interesting way to go about this. You know, honestly, pretty smart. And so, you know, I was kind of drawn to this case before anyone even requested it. Just because, you know, I have family members who are on the autistic spectrum. So for me, like, I can somewhat put myself in those people's shoes, like his family, because I don't even know what would happen. Like, I don't even know how I'd feel if my cousin went missing. Like, fuck, I'd be out there myself helping to look. But so, you know, I'm going to relay the facts of what we do know and then go through my channeled notes. And you guys can, I don't know, decide for yourself what you think. And if you want, you can use your own interpretations of my notes. Because, you know, I can get these images, I can get these symbols, but it's just a matter of interpretation. And sometimes I'm wrong with how I interpret these things. So guys, if you know any information that maybe I don't know, because I'll be honest, the only information I know about this case is what I saw on, you know, the Foreman Brothers video. That's all I know. So, without further ado, here are the facts. So, this child is a 15-year-old autistic boy that is, you know, high-functioning autistic from Hendersonville, Tennessee. He went missing the night of February 25th, 2024. Mother went to wake him up the next day for school and saw he was missing. Monday, February 26th, she contacted law enforcement and they issued an endangered child alert at 11:17 a.m., was last wearing a black sweatshirt, black sweatpants, and his glasses. According to his family, his shoes were still inside the house, and there were no signs of forced entry. There was a local search within a five-mile radius of the house, yielding no answers. Thursday, February 29th, a local pond was drained, still no information. On Thursday, March 7th, a local landfill in White Plains, Kentucky was searched, and they just wanted to, you know, check the family's garbage. But again, no answers. The family claimed Sebastian would never leave without his shoes and would never wander off. And there is a camera that showed three specks of light at 3 a.m. or 3:10 a.m. And police suspected that there were two of them with flashlights moving towards, you know, one another. But so, you know, after I did my channel, I watched this video by Christina Randall, and she did a really good job covering, you know, the basics and even more information that, you know, most people aren't talking about. And information that makes you go, that's weird, that's suspicious, you know? So, I just wanted to, and I'll even link her video up here so you guys can go and watch it, because she does a really good job at covering it. And yeah, so, and guys, I have a surprise at the end, so please stick around to watch the entire video so you can see this. Let's get to the channeled information, shall we? The first psychic impression that I got, I heard father and then sweatshirt. So one thing I learned, you know, after doing this is that, you know, he has a stepfather that he's living with his mother, and then the biological father, you know, lives somewhere else, but they have shared custody. So that's weird. Glasses. I had a vision of glasses being found in, on, near, like, a back seat of a vehicle on leather seats. Now, here's the thing with interpretations. Could it be metaphorical? Could it be, like, literal? Could it be symbolic of something? Maybe it doesn't necessarily mean that his glasses are in the backseat of somebody's car, but maybe there's, like, some kind of, I don't know, reference to that. So I just want to point that out, that sometimes these impressions aren't always literal, and there's symbology here. All right, my clairsentience, forgot what that was called, kicked in, and I started getting leg pain, knee pain, ankle pain on both limbs. I felt crying. My left shoulder and upper arms were hurting and were sore. It felt like I got punched, or there was some kind of like trauma to those areas. My ribs were starting to hurt. Oh, this is a big one. This one I felt so like vividly, shaking from fear and cold. Now, I could feel it in my jaw. You ever like are outside and you're not dressed appropriately and it's cold as fuck, and you're so cold that your jaw kind of just like moves on its own? That's what it felt like. And I was cold. I could feel the cold on my body. But essentially, it was like a jaw spasm, teeth jittering, chattering. I felt nausea. I felt a lot of nausea. Pain in my upper abdomen. Head pain right above the left brow and left side above the ear. Heart pain, shaky. Then I got the Cardi B meme. That's suspicious. That's weird. Someone is definitely going to show strange and perhaps incriminating behavior. And then I heard follow it. And then when I heard that, I just happened to look and my clock said 4:44 a.m. So I saw a cross, like, you know, the butted cross. This could mean anything, but my first impression of this was deceased or has crossed over. But at this point, I wasn't sure because when I'm communicating, I don't always see the person I'm communicating with. Sometimes it's my guides giving me the information. And sometimes it's the actual person. So like when I did Dylan Rounds, it was him. Whereas here, I didn't see who was giving it to me. It felt more like my guides. But then I felt more of his body sensations. So, yes, anyway. I heard left in the dark. I then saw a foot coming down. And the point of view was like, I'm looking up from the ground as the foot's coming down on me. Like I'm a bug being stomped on. Then it goes dark. I see a building. I see a long building. It's like a single floor building. I hear the word butler. Then I get a bunch of random pictures. Again, I'll put it up here. I hear, you must be true to your heart, which is a song by 98 Degrees from Mulan, and it's called True to Your Heart. You must be true to your heart. So I hear it in song version. I then see a bed with no bed sheets or blankets on it. Just white. Like, you know how the covers are taken off and then you have, like, the white either mattress or the mattress cover. I then see a bird flying in the sky. And I'm hearing, maybe pay attention to bird behavior. Like, if there are some circling an area, like, maybe go over there and look. I saw a long glass bottle with a cork on the top. I don't know if it's like a wine bottle, but it was like a clear bottle with a white label. So I don't know. Again, I see another large foot stepping on a person on the ground. I see a toy airplane. Again, nausea. Feel a wooden popsicle stick on my tongue that triggers a gag reflex and nausea. So like, you know how a doctor will check your tonsils or your throat and they'll put the stick? This didn't feel like it was voluntary. Like, it didn't feel like that. It felt like it was forced. And then this is where I get abuse elements. I'm not claiming, I'm not blaming, I'm just pointing out my notes, okay? I see a mushroom, and then I start seeing this over and over and over again. Probably like 10 to 20 times, I see a small shack. It's like square, wooden, and I'm looking at it from the ground perspective. I'm like laying on the ground and I'm like looking at this place, like this structure. Man in a black winter coat and hat. At least it looks black because it's nighttime when I'm seeing this. This person is like between the ages of 35 and 45. There's stubble on the face, brown hair, medium build. Again, building structure in my face, wooden barn, shed, shack. I don't know what it is. But yeah, like I said, I've been seeing this image over and over and over again. I then see like a sign, kind of like when you visit a tourist area or like fancy farms. Sometimes they'll have like this specific kind of sign out in the front or near like a building, but usually it's like out kind of near the road or the driveway, if that makes sense. But the area in general is giving me immense anxiety. I see a painted lady butterfly. If you don't know what that is, Google it. And I drew pictures of the man. I get an image of a chalice. And I also get images of three crosses, like, all next to each other. Back to the man. He has shorter, like, dark hair. Again, I'm viewing this like it's nighttime. So I don't know if it's, like, black hair or dark brown hair. I just know it's dark hair. It ain't blonde. And his hair's kind of, like, messy, like, hat hair. At first, when I saw the man, he was wearing a hat. But then when he doesn't wear a hat, it's, like, kind of messy on the top and somewhat shorter in the back. And again, he's giving 35 to 45, 50 years old would be pushing it. To the crosses again, because again, all the shit is never in order. It's just as it comes. So, I had to look up what three crosses mean, like three white crosses, because I saw three white crosses. I was like, what does that mean? Like, I'm not Christian. I don't know the references. So, in Calvary, crucified with two thieves. At this point, I'm thinking there's two people involved. And the third cross would be like Jesus. The Holy Grail would be like the person they're searching for. Kind of like how you search for the Holy Grail. Well, he, as in Sebastian, is very pure, okay? So I feel like he would be the Jesus and also the Holy Grail in this impression. Again, some other images. One, again, looks like a mushroom. The other one, I don't know what it is. You guys can tell me. It looks like it's some kind of tool. But I don't know. I'm seeing a cemetery. And to me, that's kind of like indicating, yeah, he's probably passed, which is, I hope not. I hope I'm completely fucking wrong. I don't want to be right. But I'm seeing an extremely thin teenage boy that looks like Sebastian, and it looks like he is underweight for his age and height. And again, it's giving abuse elements, but I'm not, like, you know, saying that he was or claiming anything, okay? This is just opinions, suspicions, psychic impressions, whatever you want to say. I hear tool shed. Okay, strange. But it would answer what the heck that square structure was. I'm seeing a large green and white stained glass window with vines on it in an older wooden building. I don't know what that means. Could it be a church? I don't know. There's a lot of I don't knows. I'm seeing a large white house with this, and it's kind of like somewhere almost like how some houses from the driveway or the street will have like that arch thing or the lattice with the vines and flowers around it. Again, you'll see it in my notes. I get stomach cramps. All right, so more pictures here. I start getting burning on the right shoulder blade. Neck feels limited by how far I can turn in each direction. And then I see this lady that looks like a housewife, but like house mom, with shorter, like bleach blonde hair that looks like it was just blown out. And she's going like this, like in shock. And I feel like somebody that looks like her, or I don't know, might be the one to find him. But I get images of him holding something in his hand, or some might not be him. Somebody's holding something that's important. I don't know what it is, but it looks square. You guys, again, can decide. I then see a boat, but one of those old-fashioned, like, wooden boats with the white sails. Kind of like a pirate ship, but not a pirate ship, because it has white sails. Or, yeah, white sails. Had this feeling of being watched. It was strange. I literally felt like someone was going to pull me by my ankle and drag me off the bed. I don't know. It's weird. It's weird. And then I see like this rectangle thing with these stripes. Might be blinds to a window. I'm not sure again. But the way I was seeing it was kind of dark again. Like it's nighttime and I'm seeing this like image. So I don't know if it was like blinds or like stairs, but like being seen dead on. Again, you guys can be the judge. I see a house with a big yard with a large fence that goes around it. And it looked like I saw a horse in that yard. It's almost giving like farm. I hear, came to the road. And then I heard, car involved. Alright, then I drew this image of the man. Again, dark brown hair, mustache, has gray in it, stubble around the face, cushiony material on dark coat, button-up shirt underneath. I don't know why I wrote 40 to 50 years old here, but it looks like the same guy that I saw originally. But I'm terrible with age, so I'm going to say between 35 and 50. I don't know. I'm bad with age. But you guys can decide from the photo that I drew. And then I see this three, like, leaf-looking thing. I keep seeing, like, large tendrils of what looks like the mother's hair. It's got the same wave pattern, and it's almost the same color. So it's not, like, just one strand of hair. It's, like, this thickness, but, like, with her wave pattern. In color. Again, I start seeing more boat images. The same kind, like the wooden ships and the sails. I hear sea. And then seeing a body of water with a wooden shack by it. And the thing about this shack is, it has like this wooden walkway around it. Or like a dock or a little pier. But it's not, like, a lot of walkway or pier. It's short. I heard, bit me. And then I start seeing a male person wearing a sleeveless sky blue or aqua blue, sleeveless shirt with red shorts, hunched over. And he's standing under, like, the is it called an awning? It's like the entryway on a person's porch or house. It's like part of the porch. And like the cutout is like this. It's rounded. It's not square. And then I start seeing thick woods. And then a little mound, like a little mound for a bank. And then more water. But here's this because I know it'll be hard to just insert. Alright, so I'm not going to, what's the word? I can't think of the word. assume. I'm not going to assume anything. I'm not going to claim anything. And I am not going to accuse anybody. So, again, this isn't foolproof when it comes to psychic impressions. Because, again, it comes down to deciphering them and interpretation. So those are my notes. Alright, now, to the surprise here. I thought it would be fun to let Ghost pick some cards. And so I had made my own, like, missing persons, true crime deck. Just, like, a rough draft where I just took some cards and wrote on them. And I let him pick. So I will play that here.
Ghost, you're gonna decide.
He's very sassy. He's a sassy boy. And he, like, always fights me.
Alright. Pick a card. It's your job. Pick a card. Pick a card.
I saw you look in this direction. Pick a card. Please. Do it for Sebastian Rogers, Ghost. You are very intuitive. You can do it. That one? Interesting. Come on. Do it for Sebastian. All right, pick a card. Come on. Pick a card. Stop. Get off until you pick a card. Please. Oof. Oof, Ghost. Oof. Any other cards? Any other cards? Really? Really?
And yeah, so I yeeted all these cards just to show you that I didn't, like, pre-plan this. Like, I threw them out and let him decide. So again, we're not accusing anybody. Ghost decided he picked the cards, okay? He picked. But I will say this. I think some of the behaviors of the parents are very suspicious. Now, everyone grieves in their own way. People cope in their own way. But, that's all I'm gonna say. I can't say anything. And I don't want to get in the way of the investigation. So, again, you know, plus it's innocent until proven guilty. So just because you suspect it being someone specific involved, you know, you can't do much. Because A, you don't want to get sued. But B, if that person is actually innocent, or people, because I think there's two involved, again, you don't want to mess up the case or the investigation. So, anyway, guys, I'm going to end it here. I hope to God they find this kid alive, but I have my doubts. And, yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching. And let me know if any of my impressions make any sense. That will be very helpful. And again, thank you guys so much, and peace out.